So, my presentation is going to be on my pipeline from Polycam into Blender and sort of rigging, scanning a character, cleaning up the scan, and putting it into Mixamo for getting animations and such. I'm using the app Polycam, which you can download for free, but to do like unlimited scans and get the exports, it's about $100 a month, but I use it all the time. Basically, I'm just going around Zach. I'm having him stand like in an A pose, arm to shoulder length, and yeah, basically just going around, doing a whole 360 a few times, and then after I do that, I try and get underneath like the arms and legs because that's where it often messes up. And then here's what it nice. Looks like once you get into Polycam. It has a tendency to capture the environment around it, but that's fine because we can just crop that out. And I will always download it as a GLTF or GLB, which is just what I use to import into Blender, and that keeps all of the textures attached with it.
Oh, okay. So the OBJ doesn't do as well?
It does. Like, it packs it all together, but this is just like one file that has it all together.
Mm-hmm.
Then I just import. And
nice. Yeah,
this is generally what the mesh will look like. And it's very dense. And the quickest way I find to crop the thing out is to just select, like with the paint, do inverse and then delete all of the excess vertices, crop out the ground floor, and then we have just our base model. I'll normally, at this point, set the origin and get it everything I wanted. And with these scans, a lot of the time it has a tendency to put vertices really close together, so I'll always merge just to clean up the ones that you can't really see. And this is generally what we have. You see, he kind of has web wings, so we want to get rid of that. And you can do that by going into like sculpting. I'm just sort of struggling with this, just trying to tuck this out of the way in a really like quick way. You can go a lot like more in depth. Just like you can retexture if you want. I'm just doing this really quickly because this is not like that huge. I'm literally just like tugging it into his armpit.
Mm-hmm.
That's it. And then,
nice.
Yeah, I'll do another merge by distance just to clean up any leftover vertices. And then afterwards, you can go through and just sort of like touch up anything else that's like there's like a little bit of hair that was like sticking out how it shouldn't be. That's generally all the cleanup I will do in Blender, and then go and export as an FBX, and you want to make sure that you have it so you attach the textures to it. You'll see that Mixamo sort of does not like to cooperate all the time with that, but normally whenever you put it back in, it works.
Nice.
This is me uploading into Mixamo just the same way I did.
Wow, that's amazing.
And pinpoint where the chin, wrist, elbows, knees, and groin are, and I will normally turn off use symmetry just to get like the fine points because it's not going to be perfect like a lot of 3D models. And then you have a rigged character, and we can make him dance.
That's amazing.
And yeah, there's like a lot of fun different things you can do in Mixamo. Like you can mess with the overdrive is like how fast it's going. I have this sped up just for like time's sake, so it's a lot slower.
Uh-huh.
You can like change the arm space if they're like a bigger creature with like muscles and stuff.
Wow.
Then you just download that and you can re-import that back into Blender.
It's so great it can handle that very crazy file.
Yeah. This is a weird glitch that I've been having recently where like the textures are like fragmented, which I don't know why that's doing that. I haven't had that issue until recently. But then I'll normally just make the animation just cycle, and then we have a constantly looping Zach doing chicken dance. And that's generally the pipeline that I'll use for like all of those scan projects that I have.
Amazing.
And that's...
Wow. Could you, before you close that out, when you when you import that GLTB, is it GL? Mm-hmm. GLTB? No.
It's GLTF or GLTF. GLB. It's like the same thing.
Right. Yeah. So when you import it, do you have any trouble sometimes with the textures connecting, or it just does pretty well?
It's just automatic. Okay. It just comes in there automatically.
So that's why you like that form.
Yeah, and you can do this with Maya in a similar pipeline. I don't know the exact pipeline for Maya, but there are tutorials put out by Polycam on how to get this into Maya, how to get this into Unreal Engine.
Maya doesn't like, I don't think they yet, there might be a plugin now, but I haven't found it for the GTLFs, but, mm-hmm. or GLBs, but I would bring it into Blender, and then if you wanted to work in Maya, you could just do an FBX export.
Yeah, that's basically the pipeline.
That's so good. Yeah, that's amazing that Mixamo doesn't mind it being so high resolution. Mm-hmm. And when it brings it back, it's still really high resolution. It's just that the rig works mm-hmm. pretty well. Nice. Questions from the audience? Anyone? That's fantastic. So fast. Anyone? Come on. Somebody's got to have a question. How about when you export? Oh, go ahead. Please.
Like, what if you wanted to put something in my hand and then, like,
good question.
Like, if there's a sword, if you wanted to give me like a sword, for example, and then have me do a sword animation, how would you go about doing that?
I would probably just, you could do it a couple ways. You can make you can model a sword and then attach it to the rig in a way that you normally would. So just have your character put it into Mixamo, just like in like a holding motion. You could scan it with like, maybe your arm is like in this shape. And then put it in Mixamo, and there are animations for like, you know, swinging a sword, and then I would probably download that, put that in, and then attach the sword to the hand. I've actually done that with a lightsaber, so yeah.
Nice. And then when you're exporting from Blender to go to Mixamo, you said you made sure to keep the textures on. Was that a setting that's just in the export function?
It's when you go to export as an FBX, you have these options.
Okay.
And you set the path mode to copy, and then there's this small icon right here that's just like a box. And you just click on that, and it links the textures to it. And I'll also normally do limit to selected objects in case I have anything else in the scene that I don't want exported.
Yeah, great. Wow. Any other questions? That was great. Yeah. Yes. Mm-hmm.
So if you were to say had longer hair on your character, would you be able to apply hair crystals?
No, because it would come out as just one mesh. I guess if I wanted to do that, my workaround would be, I would be like, put your hair up as tight as you can get it and then add the hair in Blender afterwards. That's probably the best way you could do that, because it's just going to come out as one jump. Like, this will be part of the mesh.
Yeah, good question. Anyone else? Wonderful. Yay!